What's up, everyone? It's Q from Retro Q Gaming, and I want to talk about one of the most disappointing things to happen this year in gaming, and just of one of the most disappointing things of the last few years, actually, which has been a significant amount of stream of disappointments. But as you've no doubt surmised from probably the name of this video and the thumbnail that accompanied it, I want to talk about Arkham Knight, specifically the PC version of Arkham Knight, and just not just the PC version, but that is included in it too. So we all know a while back, a couple of years ago at this point, I think it was, that Arkham Knight was announced to be the conclusion of the Rocksteady trilogy of Arkham games. Eventually, it was delayed a couple of times, and there was a significant delay. I believe it was in January of this year, or it was delayed from either January or February of this year up until June, and then it was delayed again by like 2 or 3 weeks. So those are some of the first warning signs anyway. I mean, when a game is delayed like 6+ months, I think altogether it from its original announced release date, I think it was delayed by like a year altogether. I can't really remember. I'm not 100% sure. Might have been just under a year. I think it was originally slated to come out so around this time last year. But ever since then, like that's some sketchy stuff and some scary news anyway. So we'll fast forward a little bit more anyway, and there was closer to release, I think it was like a week, maybe 2 weeks before release. I actually made a video about this next topic, but the highly coveted and fairly rare, because not everywhere was doing them and it was a limited quantity of them, the Batmobile edition. There was three standard editions of the game. There was the standard edition, there was the, I don't know why I said three standard editions, there was three editions of the game. There was the standard edition, there was the what's known as Memorial Edition. It was basically the statue with a statue of Batman kind of thing, as well as a bunch of other stuff in the box, but it was all standard fare, really, DLC, blah blah blah. And you had the Batmobile Edition, which came with a scale replica of the Batmobile, and it looked pretty cool. It was a big, expensive looking thing. I think it was about $250 at the time, something like that. But then about a week or two before release, Warner Brothers, I don't think it was Rocksteady, but so Warner Brothers actually announced that it's like, oh well, we had to cancel every Batmobile edition in the world because it's not up to our standards a week before release. I'm like, really, Warner Brothers? So that was one big sketchy thing off the bat straight away. A second one was a few days before release. See, I was going to get it on the PS4. Mainly because I wanted... No, did I... Was I going to get on PS4 or Xbox One? I think it was buying on Xbox One because I originally wanted to buy the Batmobile Edition, but it was announced that the special editions were going to be console only. So I was like, okay, I'll get the Batmobile Edition. Boom, it's not available around here. Oh, it's like, okay, that's a problem. So I ordered the Memorial Edition, the one with the Batman statue, and what happened with that was about 2 or 3 days before release. This was after the Batmobile announcement, but before the game actually released, I got an email from Amazon. It said, well, listen, your order can't be processed because we've received word from Warner Brothers that there's a problem with the packaging. I'm like, okay, that's a bit weird. And you know, some of my other friends and people I knew all around Europe, they had the same issue, all mostly coming from Amazon. And it's like, okay, that's pretty strange. Again, I made a video on this as well, but they're all in my channel. You can easily find them. Just skip back about 3 months. And what Amazon said they were going to do was, Amazon said, it's like, we realize this isn't what you wanted when you wanted to order the game with us, so we'll give you a free Xbox One download code. So they about, I think it was like the midnight or maybe later in the day of the first day of official release, they actually emailed me the code, and it was a download code to download the game on Xbox One. And at the same time, they sent in the same email, they sent me an updated an updated shipping time, and they had quoted me about a month from the original thing, because the game released on, what was it, 21st of June or 23rd of June, either way, it was in around there, and Amazon quoted, it's like, okay, we'll, you know, we've got a new quote from Warner Brothers, and we should have this game to you no later than, I don't know, I think they said like the 20th of July, so I was like, okay, I that's not really an issue. I only wanted it for the statue. And one thing I also forgot to mention here as well, but will come into play significantly now in a minute. The reason why I was only buying the console version for the statue and the extra crap that came with it was because I was originally going to buy it on Steam on PC, just, you know, buy it through Steam. But it turns out that a friend of mine, he was asking me to help him build a new PC. Now, this guy, I've known him for years. He lives in America, but he's, you know, he wanted a new PC, and I was helping him build it anyway. And he really only wanted it to play one game, and he still wanted a fairly powerful one because he wanted to play it at max, and he wanted to maybe play one or two other games. So I was like, okay, you know, just we talked it over, and it's like, buy this, and this, and all. So he ended up getting a GTX 980. Under my advisement. He wanted, I think it was a 970, but I was having none of that. But anyway, because his graphics card came with Arkham Knight, a free copy of Arkham Knight, he gave it to me because he had no interest in playing, and it was like a thank you for helping him build a PC. So obviously I'm very thankful for him saving me €50, especially considering what happened with Arkham Knight, which we'll get to know in a second. But other than that, that's basically the start of the story. Before I get on to the big part of it, the whole PC condition thing, which you probably already know about. So before I get on to that, I just want to mention as well that during all this, Rocksteady or Warner Brothers or both, whatever way you want to look at it, had announced that there's going to be a season pass. Now that set off millions of alarm bells with me again, because I took to the internet talking logically with people when I could, because most people, or, well, you know, a lot of these people are just fanboys and just, they're idiots. So, I took to it logically. I was like, okay, hang on. You look at all, I don't think there was any DLC for Arkham Asylum, but I used Arkham City as my example. I was like, okay, it's almost all challenge maps and skins. There was one story related, I think there was only one story related DLC for Arkham City, and it was crap. Now, yeah, take that as whatever way you will. But the point is, it was generally subpar compared to the rest of the game. And that made me really worrisome about the season pass for Arkham Knight. Because I saw what they were going to add in. There was challenge maps, there was skins, there was racetracks, there was a bunch of other crap, and there was, I think they mentioned, I think it was three story-related DLCs altogether, once the whole thing would have been done. But either way, I used all this as an example. I was like, okay, hang on, historically, their Batman DLC has been crap, so everyone please hold off on this. And naturally, the fanboys going to fanboys, so there was no helping them. But then, when the game, this actually ties into the release of the game. So when the game actually released, the Harley Quinn DLC was available, and straight away, that got panned for being useless. So I was like, okay, hang on, people. I predicted this to you for good reason. Please, because you'd get the Harley Quinn DLC with, I think it was pre-orders. So I was like, hang on, people. If you haven't bought the season pass, use this as an example. Please, use logic and reason. Listen. And it was like, no. The rest is going to be better. And then the next one coming up was the Batgirl themed one. Now, a lot of people were very excited to play about Batgirl because this was the first time Batgirl would ever be playable in any Batman game as far as I can remember. And then when this came out, when the Batgirl, I think it's A Matter of Family, I think it's called, when that DLC came out, that got panned as well for being crap. And then Rocksteady came out and was like, well, maybe it wasn't Rocksteady, I think it was Warner Bros. And they came out and said, well, you know, the Batgirl DLC isn't developed by Rocksteady, but the rest of it will be. So that's a whole thing anyway, and that's a whole other issue. And again, at this point, people had bought the season passes, and people were feeling a bit scorned by it. And with the new newest DLC as well, the Catwoman style one, it's basically most likely going to be the same. I mean, when the announcement of the Catwoman DLC and when it was going to happen, it wasn't met by yeah, time to go back and play Arkham Knight. It was met by a resounding fuck it. I mean, people have paid for a game. People have paid for the season pass, and because of everything that's happened and quality of the DLC wise, you know, it's just people just don't care anymore. Now, from what I understand, it's very, very conflicting, so I don't know who to believe on it. So I'm gonna throw out both things. Some people will say and provide what seem to be logical arguments. Remember, I haven't played Batman because of just all the stuff in this video, as well as something we'll get into now in a minute. But a lot of people say Arkham Knight is the best of the trilogy, and they give what seem to be logical reasons for it. And a significant amount of people also say that the Arkham Knight is the worst game of the trilogy. So, and they also provide logical reasons why. So it, you know, I have no idea really at the end of it. But between all that, the one thing that does remain consistent is the resounding DLC is crap message from everyone on every platform, that it just feels like a cut down, lower rate version of any part of the game with a different skin on it. And that's what I understand anyway, but like I said, I haven't played that stuff myself. Now, so let's get on to the main bulk of this thing. I mean, I know this video has gone on for longer than I thought it would in the first place, but I've already mentioned that I did get a free copy of Batman Arkham Knight from my friend who I helped build his PC with him. Now, so naturally, I was thankful for that. That saved me €50, or I think it was 60. Yeah, €50. I think it was €50. But anyway, that saved me a bunch of money on there. Now, I preloaded the game, as most sane people would do. I turned on the game the shortly after its release. And what I was greeted with was not good. Not good at all. Now, if you remember, I'm sure everyone knows about this. Even if you're not a PC gamer, I'm sure you've heard about the absolute debacle that happened during the months, not just the months of June, from June up until now, that's still happening. I mean, this is the reason why I'm making this video now. 3 months on, this is still happening. So, essentially, the game launched on PC with possibly the worst PC port of all time, or definitely one of them. And given the fact that a lot of games have shitty, broken PC ports, especially in the last few years, the fact that this would be the worst one significantly screams about the quality of it, or the lack of quality of it even. So it had all sorts of ridiculous stuff. The game was hard capped at 30 FPS. Now, you could, you know, have workarounds and stuff like that, but the game could play a bit wonky if you did that, because, you know, when you're editing config files rather than doing it differently, it can get a bit sketchy. But the fact is that Nvidia and Rocksteady, mind you, had always been talking about how great they were working with the PC version and all, and it turns out that they didn't do the PC version at all. But between Rocksteady, Warner Brothers, and Nvidia, like I said, I'm not an Nvidia fanboy. I'm obviously criticizing them here, and I do use Nvidia, but they were showing off all their game demos and their tech demos and their Nvidia GameWorks technology running at 60 FPS, which the game could not legitimately run at. And then coupled with, there's so much other stuff that there was game-breaking, I won't even call them bugs, there were game-breaking technological bugs, essentially. Stuff wouldn't recognize certain graphics cards, it wouldn't recognize that you had a certain amount of RAM, it wouldn't, video RAM, I should say, so you could unlock better options and stuff like that. The gameplay was some of the most unoptimized, and the game graphics settings were just some of the most unoptimized settings ever used. Here's a perfect example. Since the game was capped at 30 FPS, you could go in and use the in-game benchmark You could use the benchmark from the main menu of the game. And the benchmark wasn't capped at 60 FPS. Or sorry, it wasn't capped at 30 FPS. But the game was. So, the fact that some of the stuff just wasn't implemented properly at all. And some of the graphic settings were completely missing. And a perfect example is of how horribly unoptimized it was. I ran the benchmark. When I first turned the game on, I ran the benchmark. I put it to my resolution, which is 2560 by 1440. I put it to that resolution. And what I did was I turned everything up to max. So I turned everything up to max. And I was getting approximately... It would vary depending on what was happening. But I would average in around 40-odd FPS. Now, that's understandable. My graphics card, it was top of the line 3 years ago when I bought it. So, I mean... I was really only doing it for stress test purposes because I knew there was no way I was going to be playing Arkham Knight on, you know, 2560 by 1440 at a minimum of 60 FPS, but everything turned to max. I just knew that wasn't going to happen. But I wanted to do it as a stress test so that way I could gauge where I could put certain settings and then move it around and all based on that. So at that resolution, with everything maxed, I was getting an average of in around 40 FPS. So then I started turning down some of the settings. I turned off all the NVIDIA GameWorks stuff, mainly because that's designed for newer generations of graphics cards than I have. But other than that, I turned all those off and I turned one or two settings down. And I actually got a lower frame rate. I was hovering around the 30s. I was like, okay, hang on, this doesn't make sense. So I turned everything down to the lowest settings. I turned everything off that was completely optional. And I turned everything else to the lowest settings. And I was getting in the 20s of frame rates. So I was like, hang on, this makes no sense. So what I did as another test, I put the game down to the very, very lowest resolution. Which I think was something like 640 by 480 or 800 by 600 or something like that. I can't remember. But the fact is, On the lowest, the absolute lowest possible graphics settings and the lowest possible resolution settings, I was getting worse performance. I was hovering or in the 20s when I did that. Versus everything at max, at full resolution, being at in the 40s FPS. So that just goes to show how unoptimized and absolutely broken the game was. So naturally, Steam, YouTube, Twitter, I don't know, probably Facebook, the internet, Kotaku, all the media outlets, they all exploded with news of this huge high-profile game being absolutely panned for the worst PC port of all time. And then suddenly Rocksteady, who were always ready to take credit for the high-end PC version, suddenly started talking about, oh, well, we outsourced it to our external development partners. People were always asking, like, who are these? And it's, oh, our external development partners. It was a real Indiana Jones-style thing. It's like, top men kind of thing. One of you people who's watching the video should probably get a good laugh out of that top men thing. It's a personal joke we have between each other. But anyway, that's not even beside the point. But the main thing is the internet and the world exploded. Console forums, like places that talked really just about consoles, were reporting on this because it was such a giant fuck up. And it turns out that the studio behind the PC port, which is Iron Galaxy, they have also made a bunch of other ports for other consoles, as well as their own individual, you know, original games. But their ports are generally considered to be terrible. I mean, some of them out there, I won't name names of games, but some of them are considered some of the worst ports of all time. And some of their original games are considered absolutely awful. So, suddenly, Rocksteady and Warner Brothers are pushing off the blame. And finally, for the first time, not taking credit for all this, quote, high-end PC work, and unquote, that they're doing. And suddenly they're pushing it off onto this other studio that they've been very secret and silent about this entire time until it all blew up in their faces. So it got to the point where they issued a couple of small patches as quick as possible. And they did basically nothing. Also, the game had a massive memory leak. From running the benchmark like four times, like I mentioned, I was using like 16, 18 gig of RAM. That's ridiculous. Now, I've got a 32 gig, but that's still ridiculous. I mean, that's a massive memory leak. So it got to the point where, I was going to say Rocksteady, where Warner Brothers actually pulled the game from PC sale. So they were recalling physical PC copies, and they removed it from sale from Steam. Now, as of making this video on the 26th of the 9th, 2015, at 5 p.m. GMT, Batman Arkham Knight is still unavailable for sale. So, to go with all that is, Warner Bros. Announced what they would call an interim patch. Now, this was supposed to, it was supposed to significantly improve, but not make the game to a sellable level, if you will. It was significant because some people didn't have too many problems playing it. I mean, there was some people with massive, significant problems like I had. And just many, many, many people had. But there was some people that could kind of, they weren't really affected by it too much for some reason. It's not just the people with the extremely powerful PCs that could literally brute force it. For some reason, some of the other people just could work moderately well. I won't even say relatively well, but just moderately well. And if you were one of those people that could run the game moderately well, this interim patch, which was designed to come out in August, was supposed to help you out, essentially. It added a bunch of new graphic settings, a bunch of tweaks, fixes, optimizations, etc., etc. And that eventually got pushed back, and it came out at the start of September. So once that patch actually came out, a lot of people who, as I said, were playing the game moderately well beforehand, they've reported significant improvements. It's still not up to a proper release standard from everything I hear. You see reviews and stuff that have been changed and talking about post-patch performance and post-patch experience and technological standpoints and all. But apparently it's still not up to a full release game. So that's pretty bad. I know, like I said, I haven't played Batman Arkham Knight at this point because I was one of the people that would not benefit from the interim patch. I did not try the interim patch, but it's widely accepted that if you were one of the people that could play moderately well, this interim patch is for you. If you were one of the people who could not play the game at all because of the absolute shit it was, this patch is going to do basically nothing for you. Because they do plan, they have announced that they're going to work on another full patch to bring the game up to proper release standards. So when that will be, who knows. It's too late in my opinion at this point, because I'll use myself as the perfect example. So about a week ago, maybe even less, once I heard about the latest DLC, the Catwoman DLC, I remember just thinking, like, oh yeah, Batman Arkham Knight actually released. I mean, that's a game that actually exists. Completely forgot about that. Because I know I have it on the Xbox One, technically, because Amazon didn't revoke my code. But, I mean, I don't want to play it at, like, what was it, 900p, 30 FPS or something like that. I'm used to playing Batman games at a considerably higher resolution settings and frame rate. So I'm not bashing consoles here, people. Just don't reach for your keyboards already. I'm just saying it's, you know, there's a reason I wanted to play it on PC, because it's just what it was. So it made me realize that I'd actually completely forgot about the game. And I completely forgot that it even existed or released or anything like that. And that really killed me inside, because I love Batman. I mean, I'm a huge Batman fan from as early as I can remember, from the early 90s. Batman the Animated Series, absolutely love it. Like I mentioned earlier in the video as well, Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, I loved those games. I even met Kevin Conroy last year. I have a picture of me and him, and he signed my Arkham City as well. So, I mean, that's huge to me. And to see Batman and all that just be treated like this, it's so disheartening. And at the same time, is because I didn't care about Arkham Knight anymore, I actually asked my friend who 100%ed the game what he thought, who the Arkham Knight actually was. Don't worry, I'm not going to spoil it. I'm not going to give any spoilers about the game, obviously. But the fact, it just goes to show that I cared so little about the game. I'm a huge anti-spoiler person, by the way. So, I mean, I'll try avoid absolutely everything to try avoid even a small type of spoiler. And the fact that I would actually ask him this really shows that I've just given up on it, unfortunately. So he told me anyway. Well, he asked me, he's like, do you really want to know? It's a massive spoiler. I was like, yeah, just tell me anyway. So he told me, and then he explained a couple of the things throughout that when he thought it was, and some of the stuff that happened in the story that was and wasn't related to the Arkham Knight. But That's basically how it goes. Anyway, that just goes to show that how little anyone cares at the moment, or at least how little I care at the moment. But one thing that seems to just be a resounding success is despite the initial praise that the game and release and everything about how it was handled, not just on the PC version, but just the brand and the game itself in general, has been a massive disappointment and a massive failure. Now, that's what I see from media outlets. That's what I see from tons of different comments and forums everywhere. I mean, the negative comments outweigh the positive comments by about 10 to 1. It's such a significant amount. And there's so many different reasons, so many of which are actually logical. So it really gets my goat that Batman and... Well, that's something Batman is associated with has fallen from so far from the grace it was. Now, I'm going to wrap the video up here pretty much. So it just goes to say, with developers and publishers and all, because it turns out that there was a report published, there was actually like several of them, that Warner Brothers knew that this PC port was absolute shit, and they just said, fuck it, push it out anyway, it's good enough. And there's also other reports that people were reporting some of these major game-breaking glitches and bugs and, you know, technological failings up to a year before release, and they just did nothing about it. So, I mean, what does that tell you about companies and all? I mean, you can call me a conspiracy theorist if you want, but at the end of the day, these companies are trying to squeeze as much money as possible while doing as little work as possible. Batman Arkham Knight's PC port is a perfect example of that. So that's where I'm going to start wrapping it up again anyway, because that last point just kind of escaped me. I should really script these videos. It would make a lot more sense, and it would make it easier, but I don't know. It's just doesn't really feel that natural. So disappointing. But anyway, I digress. Let me know in the comment section below anything you think about the entire, you know, anything Arkham Knight related at all. I mean, between the original delays for almost a year, if not a year, again, I don't remember the exact dates, or one of the many, many, many things that has gone wrong with publishing, development, PC versions, console versions, physical editions, collector's editions, whatever. There's a million and one things that we could talk about in this video. So let me know in the comment section below anything, on your opinion on anything Arkham Knight related at all. As well as one thing I do want to throw in as well, anything with a Rocksteady name on it now, or anything with a Warner Brothers name on it now, is automatically don't buy now, possibly buy later. That's just to me personally, and I would urge you guys to do the same thing. So let me know all that kind of stuff in the comment section below. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. You can follow me on Twitter, details in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the rest of the videos in my channel while this video has gone on way, way too long.